Welcome back to the 590 studio. I'm Tom Deacon.
We're Tom Deacon.
Talisa, N-dubs, nah. I think you'll find I am.
We are Tom Deacon.
No, I am.
We is
Tom Deacon.
Yard.
Get it?
We're them homegrown entrepreneurs, platinum selling, whatever you want to call it, none of night.
And you're watching BBC Switch.
Booyah!
It's almost been a year since cousins Talisa Deppi and friend Faiza were dropped from their record label. They were mad upset with no idea how they were going to conquer the music world. Since then, however, they've completely had a U-turn and N-dubs have become one of the biggest selling groups in the country.
Hello, hi, not the N-dubs.
Nice, N-dubs.
Flip, N-double-A. South's finest, N-dubs.
Northwest best, N-dubs.
N-dubs, Repcon.
So let's find out how Talisa, Deppi and Faiza prepare for their first ever UK tour. It was the final night of the N-dubs tour. Having sold out all their 22 dates, I met up with the guys backstage in London to see how they were dealing with their new fan success.
You looked outside at all the fans?
No, I can't continue to see them.
This girl outside, she's dressed in one of your stage outfits completely.
Talisa actually wore this on some of the dates on tour.
12.
Do a 12.
More excited because it's London, hometown.
Yeah, man.
I thought family and friends were coming today. Dad and Rick tomorrow.
No, my family and friends.
Today.
I've got 43 people coming today.
You've got like some proper like hood fans today.
Yeah?
Mm.
And how are they looking? What are they wearing?
Hoodies, the girls are like wearing their gloves and their jackets.
What, girls, yeah? There's a majority of girls there.
Oh, there's the boys.
You've got the whole Deppi tracksuit going on and everything. Is this like as a kind of tribute to Deppi?
Yeah, I mean, I like it as well, so I thought it's a good opportunity to wear it.
What's the majority?
Girls.
All right, favourite member?
Deppi.
Could you all tell me why N-dubs fans love Deppi so much?
What is it about the little guy with the hat?
He's a very good guy. If you know him, he's a very good guy.
Big heart.
Very big heart, very good soul. But he's a lunatic.
Do what they do. They're going to be going mental.
Talisa's got lovely big man.
Yes,
she says
looks
it
so
how it
pretty.
Is.
She looks so pretty, but they're little terrors.
Shut up!
Out of the group, I must be in trouble the most.
Faiza, we're on.
Faiza,
we're on.
Let's go. No, now.
I'm used to getting into trouble, but I know when time gets to me to do the work, I will smash my job. I will deliver.
I never thought I would ever get this far, but I guess I was wrong. Work. To me, there's no such thing as giving up. You can do anything you want to do. Keep at it, then you'll succeed.
Hasn't come easy for N-dubs. They've been working really hard for years. In fact, it all started right here in Camden. Back in 2000, Deppi's dad, Uncle B, decided to put the three troublesome kids together and form a group. He became their manager as well as their mentor. Just as things started to take off, bad news. They got dropped from their record label and then Uncle B unexpectedly died. The group were devastated.
Been working since the age of 9. And it hasn't all been laughs and smiles, and it's been hard work.
What is it about N-dubs that you guys love?
The way they came from nothing.
Yeah. Deppi, this is exciting.
It is.
Think about where you've come from and where you are now.
Yeah.
I've seen them struggle for about 12, 13 years. We did suffer a lot, chasing them on the streets and so on, but luckily, they had their recording studio, and that was the power, because they fell in love with it.
I love music. I couldn't want to do anything else in life. All I want to do is music. I'm very passionate about it, extremely. I couldn't live without my music. That is all I want to do.
No one can say that we haven't really put the work in. It's just been 9 years of grafting, and to actually have something to come back now and to see the success is, like, amazing.
I first met these kids just after their father had died.
the big record company is trying to tell Dapper what the next single should be, and Dapper just turned around and said, how can someone know what my fans want? I know what my fans want. My fans want Ouch as a single. And the record label said, no, Ouch will never be a hit. So Dapper said, I'll do it myself then. And that's what N-Dubs did.
She the type of lady, eh, that every man needs. She straight up feisty. She keeps me on my feet, but I wanna pick things up by chicks.
Some mother, and I bet. What do you take me for? The hell with you?
To hell with me?
Yeah. I didn't wanna see your face again.
Where the do you think you is going? Go.
It became a hit all around the world. The record label that I sound to supported them, and the rest of the career is now history.
South's finest, N-Dubs.
Northwest best, N-Dubs.
The death of Dappy's dad affected the group profoundly, as he never got to see their success while he was alive. As a way of celebrating his life, they remember him in one of their most personal songs.
You know what, when you go out, what's the one song you're looking forward to performing the most? Is there one?
Yeah, it's my favourite song on the album, Papa If You Can Hear Me, Uncle B Dedication. Uncle B,
yeah. Mean a boy, you know my name. Chill for a second, just hear my pain. If you've lost any loved ones, you feel what I'm saying. The hope is peaceful down there with Elaine.
That's Uncle B. That's the person who got him up here in the first place. And he's not around anymore.
All I got is these pictures of ya, and your light blue broke down, knock ya. Things in my house still smell of ya.
If it weren't for Dappy's dad, they wouldn't be here today. And they wouldn't be the group that they are today.
R.I.P. Uncle B.
It was him and I that took the kids.
Yeah.
And started them off and saw the potential. And, yeah, they are.
You dedicate that to your dad, right?
Yeah.
That's nice. Show it to the camera, actually. Look, that's really nice.
What I say is that, Papa, if you can hear me, I regret every bad thing that I say. Please forgive me if you hear me. Never knew how much I loved you till you was there.
The thing that makes N-Dubs so special is their relationship with each other. So I went to their tour rehearsals to witness the group dynamic in action. It became quite obvious from the start that Talisa was in charge.
Your name position, your name position, here, here. Closer, closer.
Like, Dappy and T, obviously, they're cousins and stuff, and they fight and they go back and forth. They have this bit of rivalry, but they seem so close.
Yeah, they're cousins, you're not going to get any closer.
Did you ever pull them apart, though, when they were little and they're
smoking? No, no. They actually got on when they were younger. It's now they have a couple of scraps here and there, but they love each other deep down, so it doesn't really matter.
I don't know what it's going to take to snap you out of it, but you've got two choices.
You make me laugh the way you told them to focus,
like my little children.
Put the phone down, switch it off.
You're getting this on tape.
I don't want it ringing, because it's distracting you. Turn it off.
Why don't you like listen to Talisa sometimes? Like, she'll be saying focus, and you and Fraser are like messing about and doing your little thing.
Do you know what, it's like, how can I say, I want to make sure that it's done properly vocally. Mm. That's my main thing, that we sound good live.
Yeah.
They're perfectionists. Even if they hear a snare out of place or a hi-hat out of place, there's going to be drama.
And it's distracting them from what we're doing because they want it to be perfect.
Do you have the same thing? We've just had the same conversation about 25 times on each track. What is
it
you're not registering? What is not going into your head about the situation?
The fighting you've seen this evening is the passion between them, and that's, it's not negative fighting, it's positive fighting. It's kind of fighting of three young people who just are so focused on making this work.
Whatever circumstances are,
yeah,
we will adapt to it, and it's going to be the best thing ever.
We're going to go rock the show, man.
They worked hard to get to where they are today. As their fan base grows and their music develops, the Dynamite Trio N-Dubs aren't going nowhere.
Bad boy, no, no, no. Thanks to all the fans. I love you ever so much.
No, no, no.
Thank you for coming down to the show today. It was a pleasure to have you on the stage with us.
Punch up this one you for trying to make a fool of me.
But you have to get out.
So many opportunities. Look, I carry a tool for my pride and my jewellery.
Look how sexy she looks on stage and look at her now.
See me, I made a change. I didn't expect no fame. We came from practically nothing to fans and screaming our name. A-list, playlist, even my mum's famous. I would do anything for some sort of stadium status.
What did you think of your little brother's performance?
Excellent. Very proud.
Matt, give me a hug. Now we can party.
Yeah!
Yeah! I never, ever, ever, ever thought that it would ever get better. But life, it will only get better. Trust me, it will only get better.